Terry Deary, Egyptian Tale, The Magic and the Money. Chapter 1, The House of Death. Maria couldn't sleep. She lay on the cool floor of her room and eagerly with excitement. The house of death, she whispered in the dark. The house of death. And she remembered over and over again what her father had told her the night before. Maria, he said, you are a clever girl. Thank you, father, she muttered and blushed. He handed her ever seemed to notice her. He was a grand piece at the royal temple. He country good had told her she was clever before. How did he know? With the covers of bread of his hands and whispered his thin mouth, his scary dark eyes looked into her. I can't trust you, he went on. Oh, yes, father, she said quickly. I have very special task of you, he said. Her brothers and sisters were silent and looked at her. She was the oldest, and they always knew she was a special girl. She was like a mother to them since their one mouth and died years ago. Their face were still, but their ears were sitting like hippos on the bank of the Nile. Maria nodded. Tomorrow I am taking you to house of that with me, the man said. His sharp head glared in the green light of the oil lamp, and he looked like a god. Oh, her youngest brother, Caro, cried, house of death, Naria is going to die. The priest turned his head slowly and looked at his little son. The boy gave us hiccup of fear. The house of death is not the place you go to die, my son. It is the place you go after you are dead. At least, the place the great people of Egypt go when they are dead. The little boy fell open. Oh, the house of that is where we preserve the bodies of people. What's purposely? Carl whispered, father nodded. If you have a piece of meat and you leave it in the sun, what happened to it? The cat would pinch it, the little boy said. all the jackals will come in from the desert and gobble it up. Father closed his eyes and a moment and took a slow breath. If you put in the rope where the cat and the jackals could get it, Carl eagerly, the bird would eat it. The priest had heard the table so distinctly, his knocker turned wire. Naria tried to shake her head to tell her little brother to close his mouth before their father lost his temper. At last, their father said, "If we put the maid in the cage and close the door, she so the animals and birds could not eat it. What would happen to it?" Carl smiled. "Then I would open the door or the cage and I would eat it." "No, you would not," their father shouted. The children jumped as if a Nile crocodile had snapped its jaws suddenly shut. "I will tell you what happened to the meat. It would become simply and very smelly. It would be covered in flies, and the flies would lay their egg. The egg would hatch out into maggots, and the maggots would eat the meat." "Do they little smelly meat?" the boy get. "They love it," father said, "love it." He turned back to Naria. "People like us would be a little piece of meat when we died. We'd rot and smell and be eaten by maggots. That is why we have to turn people into mummies." "I know, father," Naria said. "That's what we do in the house of death. We make mummies." He roared his voice. "We are going to get very busy in the house of death someday soon. I need some extra help. Someone who can run quickly. Someone I can trust. I have chosen you, Naria." The girl felt the warm tickle in her cheek. "Thank you, father," she said, and lowered her dark eyes. In the quiet of the room, little Carlos' voice sound like a lead people. "Will I be made into a mummy, father, or will I be eaten by maggots?" Father turned on him with an angry glare. "If you do not close your monkey mouth, you will be chopped up and fed to the crocodile." "Oh," Carl cried. He jumped to his feet in fear, took a step backward, and fell over the cat. The cat squeaked, the boy squeaked, and the children tried to hide their laughter. Get to bed now, Father Lord. I will feed you to the piranha one pet crocodile. Carl feels his little leg printing faster than his thumping heart. He clutches his favorite rock ball onto his mouth. Mario assured father's tight mouth was trying not to laugh. At last, he looked around the table. In fact, you can all go to bed, he said. Sleep well, Maria. You have a busy day. You have a busy day ahead tomorrow. But Maria didn't sleep well. She hardly slept at all. Her cat crept onto her blanket and purred like a mountain lion. He stood it and whispered, "The house of that. I'm going to the house of that catkin." The cat purred. At last, the black night turned to the darkest gray, and she knew horrors, the hawk god was opening his eyes, the eye that was the sun. It was time to go.